The works behind me here are some of the examples by Aloysius O'Kelly that we are offering in our 4th of March auction. In total, we have 9 works by the artist, 8 of which come from the prestigious Belfast collection of Mervyn and Pat Solomon. Aloysius O'Kelly was born in Dublin, and he was from a family of Fenians. He had 3 brothers, 3 of them were sculptors and Fenians, and trained in London under their uncle John Lawler. Aloysius O'Kelly lived a life of art and activism, and he travelled widely throughout his career to Ireland, Britain, France, and the US, as well as North Africa. The works behind me here show an example of the artist's diversity and his travels throughout his career. In 1873, he studied in the École des Beaux-Arts in Paris, and after a time there working in the school as well as with portrait artists, he was one of the first artists to travel to Brittany and later Concarneau. After his time in France, Aloysius O'Kelly returned to Ireland in the 1880s and worked for a time as special artist to the London Illustrated News. In the early 1880s, he then travelled to North Africa with his brother James and another Fenian, Edmond O'Donovan, who we see here behind me in the watercolour of Edmond O'Donovan as an Orientalist. O'Donovan was also a Fenian and sadly lost his life in Sudan on journalistic pursuits over there. It's one of the most important political pictures by Aloysius O'Kelly, and formed part of the artist's retrospective exhibition in the Hugh Lane a number of years ago. So it's one of the more exciting works that we have in the auction, and that's guiding 800 to 1,000 euros. After his time in North Africa, the artist returned to England, where he had family. And there in the late 1880s, he painted the portrait we see here of an English peasant chopping Swedes. The work shows the artist's experience in France and working on plein air, and his interest in light and colour. Later, the artist returned to France, and the 3 landscapes beneath show examples of his works in Concarneau, 3 scenes of boats in the harbour there. His time in Concarneau was spent in the company of other artists, and he picked up many interesting and important trends which he brought back to Ireland. Later the artist travelled to the US, and from the 1900s to the mid 1930s he spent his time there, coming back from time to time to France and to Ireland. He died in the US in 1936, and he's remembered in Ireland with one of his most important works found in the collection of the National Gallery of Ireland. It's entitled Mass in a Connemara Cabin, dating to 1883, and this is the first work of an Irish subject matter to be exhibited in the Salon in Paris. So of the 9 examples, we have a nice eclectic mix of works that show the diversity and skill of Aloysius O'Kelly, ranging from guides between 800 to 1,000 euros up to 6,000 to 8,000 euros.